Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Today we're going to look at the issue of Adobe removing the 3D tools from Adobe Photoshop, and indeed the fact that Adobe continually will remove things from versions of Photoshop and what you can do about it. Now, Adobe has just let us know that the 3D tools are being removed from the most recent versions of Photoshop. So going forward, you will not have access to the 3D tools in Photoshop. Now, if you're a heavy user of 3D, there are some other alternatives which you can look at on Adobe. But what I'm doing is talking to people who occasionally would like to use the 3D tools in Photoshop. For example, to follow a YouTube video that you've seen an interesting 3D effect on. Well, you're not going to be able to access that in the most recent versions of Photoshop. And so what I suggest you do is that you keep an older version or two of Photoshop. Now, I've been saying this for a few years now. In fact, as old as Photoshop CS 5.5, because back in the days of 5.5, there were a couple of really cool features in Photoshop. One of them was the print package tool, and this allowed you to print the same image multiple times on a sheet of paper just through an interface built into Photoshop. You could also use different photos. It was just an awesome tool. I have subsequently had to create a couple of YouTube videos that will tell you how to create that same effect, not nearly as functionally as the original Photoshop tool. But I've still got that tool because I still have Photoshop CS 5.5. There was another feature in 5.5, and that was the Pixel Bender tool. Again, that has not been able to be run with later versions of Photoshop, and I have access to that because I've got 5.5 still installed on my machine. So anytime I want to create an interesting Pixel Bender effect, I can do so. Now, also in previous versions, there was a paper texture tool available inside Photoshop, not available anymore. I think you can buy it, but it used to be free. I've still got it. Now, the reason why I've still got all these things is that I've been really careful in terms of keeping older versions of Photoshop on my computers. So I have an old Windows 7 machine, which has the older versions of CS 5.5 for those days when I want to be able to access those tools. The other thing that's going in this most recent version of Photoshop will be the lighting effects. They're disappearing along with the 3D effects. So if that's you, this is what I suggest that you do, is that you go to Adobe Creative Cloud and you have a look and see what else is available in terms of older versions of Photoshop, because you are allowed as a Creative Cloud member to download and install multiple versions of Photoshop. Now, if in future I want to use lighting effects or 3D, I will still have older versions of Photoshop on my computer that I'll be able to use. There's also a very good reason for not uninstalling older versions of Photoshop when you install a brand new one, and that is simply a matter of bugs. If there's something in the newer version of Photoshop that is causing it not to run or to run not as well as you would like in some of the features that you need access to, well, if you've still got an older version of this new app on your computer, then you can start it up and at least get your work done. So just be aware of that when you're upgrading to a newer version of Photoshop or Illustrator, you're still entitled to keep those older versions on your computer, and it may be a smart thing to do. Now, all of that said, there are some features that have just been removed and are no longer functional, and that includes the color themes panel from Adobe Illustrator. That has gone because it was using a web interface. It's gone from all versions. So even if you've got an older version, that's not going to save you in terms of that feature being removed, but in terms of a lot of other features, having an older version of the application just might save you. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you've learned things about upgrading Photoshop of which you were previously unaware or hadn't thought of. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and you'll be alerted when new videos are released. Until next time, my name's Helen Bradley. Thank you so much for joining me here on my YouTube channel.